So let me tell you something, everybody. The grift from this family is breathtaking. It's breathtaking. Jared Kushner and Ivanka Kushner walk out of the White House and months later get $2 billion from the Saudis. $2 billion from the Saudis. You think it's because he's some kind of investing genius? Or do you think it's because he was sitting next to the President of the United States for 4 years doing favors for the Saudis? That's your money. That's your money he stole and gave it to his family. You know what that makes us? A banana republic. That's what it makes us. So he may get 30% again. I'm not sure. Maybe he'll get more. Maybe he'll get less. But let me tell you what he'll know in 2024 that he had no idea of in 2016. He's in for a fight to get it.
Okay, so calling out, I think, very obvious corruption. The Kushners, Jared Kushner and Ivanka Kushner, he called her? I think she's technically still Trump, isn't she? It doesn't matter, I don't care, but I think she's still Trump. But anyway, they were close to Trump. It's expected that they still are, and that if he were to become president again, he would be. And Jared Kushner's investment, whatever, was given $2 billion by the Sovereign Wealth Fund of Saudi Arabia, even though the board governing it said that that was a bad idea. They were overridden by the government. This is like the most obvious attempt to influence somebody close to the potential next president of the United States that I've ever seen. So I'm glad that he's pointing that out. And I'm glad that he's saying we're gonna get, you know, we're gonna be aggressive and all that. Was that aggressive enough though? Is he gonna be able to bring it? Like, we know that he must think that this is a long shot bid. I don't think that he has huge aspirations for his career outside of this run. So in theory, that should free you up to know that, like, I don't have to pull my punches and I don't have to worry about him attacking me, because this isn't about me. This is about me landing blows. Like, imagine if a boxer goes out and doesn't care if he gets punched. He is just going to hit that person as hard as he can. That's what Chris Christie could be. I don't know. This was more aggressive than the other stuff, JR. Will he be that person?
Yo, I like it, bro. I like it. And this is gonna, as he keeps going through these things, he's saying things that maybe a complete political on the other side of the aisle type of opponent might be saying. He described what Ivanka and Jared were up to as far as the amount of money that they took. No Republican talks like that. No Republican talks about the grift of the Republican Party and the people surrounding Donald Trump. It happened incessantly throughout his administration. People got on board so they can make money, get some kind of political power and position, if outside of the cash, of course, that comes with it. And it's the first time someone from that side of this kind of prominence would say, they stole your money. Yo, that's the kind of stuff that we hope even Democrats say that don't say it. Yeah. They stole your money. That equals banana republic. Everything that you said you thought they were doing over there in Saudi or with all these allies, that's actually not the case. They were doing it for the money. How much longer are you gonna be that sucker to be part of this system? They don't say stuff like this. And mm-hmm. This is one of those moments when you're gonna see people like me start applaud Chris Christie for saying this, and then have to wait in a couple weeks go, oh yeah, I forgot Chris Christie and his policies.
Yeah, the only way, I like everything that you said. The only modification I would probably make is generally people do not like when you point out that they've been suckered. That's the tough part. Mm. I would say, you know, there's no shame in the fact that they conned you. They've got some of the richest, best connected media people helping them in their con. Maybe I would finesse it that way, but I do totally agree mm-hmm. with you. We're gonna see. You know, let me say this to close before we go to the attacks against Chris Christie. Obviously, you know, Chris Christie, it's maybe easy to forget when he spends so much time attacking Donald Trump that he's also a Republican. By the way, one who is willing to use his office to accomplish his own corrupt, selfish ends. Bridgegate, everyone check that out. And he's definitely a Republican. But let me ask you this. Of the declared candidates, which it seems like they're the ones who are probably gonna run, maybe there'll be some other minor ones. If you had to choose from amongst them, not the person who's gonna go up against Biden, but let's say the person who becomes the president, who would you choose on the Republican side?
If I had to, anybody that's in currently, right? In the
that's
race
running, team. That's running.
Because of course, some of them more will be added. See, this is the thing, I need to analyze positions, policy positions, but whatever, I'll take debate. I'll make me go on record and make me look like an ass later. At this point, Chris Christie.
I think I would choose Chris Christie too.
Right?
If I had to choose from amongst them.
If nothing else, he's saying things that even could look damaging, because he's like, I'm gonna be honest. Who knows if that will stick around? Maybe we'll get to those points when he said, I'll be honest, when asked about the pardon, potential pardoning of Donald Trump if he's convicted of something.
Yeah,
that looked bad, and he's willing to do that. So there's some inkling of, yo, he's at least willing to be honest, even when it's bad for him.
Yeah, and he's gonna do, you know, if he were to be, you know, elected, he would do tax cuts for the rich and deregulation, all that. But all of them are going to. It's just with some of the others, they'll be more hostile to democracy and constantly pushing culture war topics that Chris Christie has rarely seemed to be particularly interested in.
And ignoring reality, like when it's right in your face, like what you're seeing is not what you're seeing.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, so we've been clear. What about all of you in the audience? What do you think? Huh? You have a better choice? I doubt it, but maybe they'll.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.